Hello and welcome, my friends and viewers, to this week's episode of Legend Lore. Here we sit and talk about 5th edition Dungeons & Dragons, specifically monsters, characters, gods, magic items, adventures, and many more, all in the hopes of educating new Dungeon Masters and players alike, and providing both advice and ideas for you guys to all use at your tables. This week, we will be going over a monster known as the Tomb Tapper, which is personally one of my favorite monsters to deploy in any game that I run. Getting right into it, the Tomb Tapper is a CR-10 construct that first appeared long ago in 1st edition, standing 15 feet tall and bearing a mostly humanoid body save for a smooth and featureless face. Often seen carrying around a colossal hammer, the Tomb Tapper also bears a very large, toothy maw on its stomach, giving it a wholly alien and strange feel. In terms of its abilities, Tomb Tappers can communicate in a number of different ways, such as using a humming sound made from skin vibrations, using simple telepathy, or emitting a high-pitched sonar and using echolocation similar to a bat. I personally prefer to use the sonar as the primary avenue of communication, due to the fact that it allows the Tomb Tapper to be able to locate invisible creatures and objects, as well as making them immune to visual hallucinations and other vision-related spells. However, this in turn can leave them quite vulnerable to spells such as silence, which is definitely some information you can give your players if they are investigating the creature and how to defeat it. Their method of communication by skin vibration, however, is actually a language that is partially understood by the Mind Flayers, or the Illithids. As such, sometimes they like to have Illithid villains bear a Tomb Tapper guardian within their lairs, communicating orders to them by use of that language so that way they can keep it secret from any invaders. This can build upon the fact that Tomb Tappers can also detect magic at will, making them absolutely effective bloodhounds when it comes to mages or anybody affected by some form of magic or spell. And of course, by virtue of being a construct, Tomb Tappers are also wholly immune to any mind-altering or charming spells, as well as a specific number of different spells such as Hold Monster and Gaius. They also bear immunity to fire and cold damage, and when killed, turn permanently into stone. Now, how to use this creature in your games? Tomb Tappers are the perfect mage-hunting construct, created by ancient arcane casters for the explicit purpose of attacking and devouring their enemies, most notably non-human arcane casters. Due to their use of both echolocation and magical detection, it is extremely difficult for anyone to be able to hide from them. As such, you could possibly use the Tomb Tapper for a sort of Resident Evil nemesis situation, where it is constantly chasing after the players and always aware of their presence, forcing them to run, hide, squeeze through tight spaces, and distract the creature in hopes of evading capture. There is, as I had said before, the use of a Tomb Tapper as a magical item bloodhound, in which one can be captured and bound to a villain to dig far deep into tombs and temples, unearthing all manner of magic items, which they can then use to serve their purpose. This allows you to have a Tomb Tapper as a part of a team of enemies for your party to face, and if the party is clever enough, they could try and free the Tomb Tapper from the service of the villain, aligning with it for the purposes of revenge. Or the villain could feed the Tomb Tapper well, giving all of its common to uncommon magical items as a form of payment and food. I've also deployed the Tomb Tapper not as an immediate monstrous encounter, but rather as a piece of decoration in the form of a statue in a rich noble's private quarters. When your party's rogue comes to disarm traps and rob the target of all their gold and riches, they won't see the creepy statue in the corner step off the platform and slowly approach, hammer ready to smash them to bits for their trespassing and their thievery. There is of course an idea for a quest in here in which a number of magic items have gone missing from either a vendor, maybe a dwarf and smith, leaving behind small tunnels and the small shards of eaten pieces of magic items. Lastly, I've also toyed with the idea of having a player character based off the Tomb Tapper, a warforged artificer made in the same vein as the Tappers themselves, cursed with a lust for magic and being forced to either collect magic items or feed off arcane power to keep themselves alive. Now when it comes to deploying the Tomb Tapper in combat, the Tomb Tapper has both a walking and a burrowing speed of 30 feet around, which means that it absolutely can ambush your players from under the ground or through cave walls. As such, you can always open up combat with a great jump scare as the Tapper's massive hand bursts through the cavern wall, grabbing the closest player before it emerges through the rest of the rock. Due to its towering 15-foot height, I also always give the Tomb Tapper the ability to grapple its enemies with both its hands and its teeth, allowing it to be able to feasibly grapple two players at once and still hold its hammer. And of course, if anyone hopes to escape the Tomb Tapper by flight, or simply running away, the Tomb Tapper can lob its hammer towards them and knock them out of the sky or on their ass. Speaking of the hammer, for a homebrew magic item this week, we have a two-handed warhammer simply known as the Tapper, which is the very weapon that most, if not all, Tomb Tappers wield. This item requires attunement and allows the wielder to cast the spell Detect Magic once per day, dealing 1d10 bludgeoning damage and 1d6 force damage on a successful hit. Furthermore, the Tapper can be thrown up to 30 feet or up to 60 feet with disadvantage, and regardless of whether or not it hit or misses the target, will return to the wielder right after, landing at their feet if they can catch it. Finally, if the target within range of the wielder casts a spell, the wielder may use their reaction to make a Mage Bane attack. On a successful hit, the Mage Bane attack deals 6d6 force damage to the target and forces them to make a DC 15 strength saving throw, or be knocked prone on a failed save. This ability can only be used once per short rest, and I've included the item's stat block in the description below. All in all, I love the Tomb Tapper, and I think it's personally one of the better monsters that Dungeons & Dragons has created and still has to offer. It has a unique look, it has very interesting lore, and the danger that it poses to magical characters makes it one of my favorite things to deploy. There's nothing quite like putting the fear of God in your players, especially if you do a little bit more tweaking and make them very strong, such as adding magic resistance, to give them advantage on any spells that do get past their immunities. If you guys like these videos and you want to see more, please click the subscribe button and press the little bell icon in the corner below. This will be able to notify you of any new videos in the coming days. And if you guys would like to support me further, please follow me on all of my social medias, and you can check out some of the Pay What You Want content that I've developed right below. All of it is 5e compatible, and I definitely urge you all to check it out. Finally, please comment down below how you guys have used Tomb Tappers in your games, or if you guys have ever fought against them. And also let me know what kind of things you guys would like me to cover in future videos. Until then, I will see you guys next time.